A small ladybug larva. Here we have something else. Some kind of aphid, I think. So, today we are out here in Boden, far up north in Sweden. And the weather is so very nice. It's 5:30 in the morning and it's like 18 degrees Celsius, sunny and a light wind. And today we're gonna do some macro photography and just see what we can find. And you're gonna follow me through the camera on my forehead. That's the concept here. Tiny hoverfly. I love photographing hoverflies, but haven't found many this summer. Maybe they come later in the summer, I'm not sure. Some kind of bug. Trying different angles. Something bit me in the thumb and it hurts really bad. I wonder what that was. I mean, I have pretty thick skin here. Ouch. Beautiful little fly. Oh. Nice to stand in the shade. There we have an interesting looking guy. I have photographed these once or twice before. but I don't know the species. Please tell me if you know. Looked pretty cool with this thing in the front, whatever it is. And he flew away. Beautiful ladybug. Oh, whoops. Oops, I think I dropped him by mistake. Sometimes it's nice to use the camera strap like this and hold it like this to have extra support from your neck. The camera strap I use, by the way, is the Peak Design Leash, which I really like. It's made for smaller cameras, but I think it works nice even on my A7 III. Even with the heavy lens, it's nice, because it doesn't take up that much space in the bag, and it's not in the way, and it's very easy to adjust it. I love that. As for equipment today, I'm using the usual things: Sony A7 III, Micael MK320 flash, my Dörr diffuser, and the Laowa 60mm macro lens. And as always, I'm linking all the products that I use in the video description below. Still thinking about that thing that stung me in the thumb. It's so very unusual for me to get stung or bitten by anything, except mosquitoes. I wonder what it was. Maybe I can be able to see it when I review the footage. But I saw something pretty large attached to my thumb, and it really hurt. So I just panicked and did like this, and then it went away. Oh, here we have a bee or something. Just chilling here. Could it have been a bee that stung me? So let's see if we can get this one. Oh, it's... hard to see anything here in the sunlight. Is it a bee? Or what is it? Perhaps just a hoverfly? Can you please turn around so I can see your face? can't use the viewfinder because my action camera is too close. So I have to use the display. I really want to get a good shot of this one, but it's really hard because it constantly turns around and the sun makes it very hard to see anything on the screen. Also, it's very windy. I'm giving up there. Hopefully I got one good shot. Maybe I didn't. I think I'm gonna walk to a new spot with some shade because it's a lot easier to do macro photography when the sun is not shining in your eyes. Up here it's sunny 24/7 this time of the year. Sun never sets. And now, even though it's like 6 in the morning, as you can see, the sun is high in the sky. Really high. This is a spot that I had some luck with 2 years ago when I was here last time. So let's try it. It's very convenient with this high plants. If there are insects on them, they are easy to reach, and also it's nice with some shade. Easier on my eyes, easier to compose. Yeah, just nice. I love photographing in places like this where there are a lot of wild flowers, because the colorful flowers make for nice backgrounds in photos. Green leaves can very easily start getting boring. And yeah, I just love colors. It's nice to have some colors in your photos. What's this bug and what's that on the back? Please tell me in the comments if you know. Beautiful little fly. Yeah, I think I got one okay shot of it. When I am at a good spot like this, I usually just walk back and forth, because then the insects that got scared away when I enter there, they slowly come back when I'm a few meters away, and the other way around. Aphids. By the way, by default I have my lens set to 2x magnification, and I shoot most of my shots there. I usually just decrease the magnification if I shoot something a bit bigger that doesn't fit in the frame. But most insects here, they do fit in the frame at 2x magnification without a problem. Oh, I think this could be a good picture. This little fly. No! That would have been a great photo if it had been in focus, but it flew away. Is this a leafhopper? I know the green ones are called leafhoppers. I guess this one as well, maybe. Even though it's brown. Gonna attempt to get some better background for this guy. I hope one of the photos was good, because I couldn't hold that stance much longer. I really like when I find a spot like this, a good spot where you can conveniently take many photos, find many insects. Then I usually stand in the same place for a long time. Because why move when you have found the spot where all the insects are? And usually it is like this, usually they concentrate in certain spots. You just have to find these and then just stay there. Where is he? Ah, not sure if that could be a good shot with the sun in the background. I do wanna try things sometimes. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Yeah, this is a nice spot. Definitely gonna try to return here before it's time to go home again in a few days. Now it's time to decrease the magnification. Slightly. What is the species of this one? I haven't photographed one before, I think. Beautiful little guy. Hopefully one of the shots was in good focus. Okay guys, it's time to wrap up. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you like this video. I make new macro photography videos every week, and I've done that for years, and I hope to continue doing that for years. And yeah, see you in a few days again. Bye bye.